Oh my God! Okay, it's happening. Everybody, stay calm.
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm.
Wait.
Everybody, calm down.
Help!
Here.
Oh,
take my hand.
Ah,
come on. You're gonna fall unless you take my hand.
No, give me your other hand.
Oh, my other hand isn't strong enough. You take my little hand.
No, get it away from me.
Break it. Break my hand.
I hear the train a-comin', it's rollin' round the bend.
Yo!
This could be the biggest train wreck of all the drawing stream train wrecks. It could be a drawing stream without any drawing whatsoever. Zilch, not even fake rectangles.
You could draw on some paper.
I don't do that.
What they want.
I have this. It's connected. But it is not going to show on the screen.
I'm going to say the obvious thing. Have you turned it off?
Yeah.
Have you turned it off and turn it back on again?
I don't think it's that. I think it's QuickTime. I'm going to say hello to everyone. Let me scroll back up. B Rose was first. Doesn't matter. Momentum's Devil Fly is in. He says his first. Hello, guys. We've got Perth Comics in here. We've got Mo Biggs. Hail the chat. Who else do we have? We have KSS. Can two CG creator YouTubers share a stream without driving each other crazy? The CG Odd Couple. That's us, Rob. We are now the CG Odd Couple. I don't know if you're aware of that. We've got Sci-Fi for me. We've got Simply Green in the house. Who else do we have here? Who else? Angela Curry, great to see. Christmas was that good, huh, Michael? I certainly ate a lot. I did go into a food coma. Merry Christmas, everyone. It's past Christmas now. SJ says, hi, Bogan. EVS's Archie Jr. movie stream sucked. I'm still reeling from it. Yeah, I'm not a fan of when they pull out the old movies and just watch it. Not my thing, but each to their own. We got Sumo Thori in the chat. Boomer, oh man, it's worked every single time and now it's not working.
Dude, you've just got to turn it off and turn it back on again. That solves 95% of computer problems for some unknown reason.
Why don't you just put it on the table and then use your other camera to capture your drawing?
Oh God.
No, when I'm serious.
When I try and turn the iPad off, all it says is say, turn off Siri. I'm trying to turn you off, you dumb thing. How do I turn you off? I think I have to press multiple things, actually.
Zay Comics in the house says, Camel looks 14.
Well, he's got his Batman PJs on.
I shaved and I cut my hair like a 12-year-old. Wait, I can look really young. There you go. Hi.
Rob, you're messing up Bancroft's grift. This way he can pretend he's drawing without us seeing that he clearly isn't.
Oh, look at me go. It's like, I just drew a whole Ella.
It's like when I played recorder in grade 6 and I was doing this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look every at time
little face says SDA. All right, I've turned it off. I'm going to turn it back on again.
Every time you play the intro, Bancroft, I always forget to ask you, would you reach up and grab that guy's hand or would you fall off the balcony?
I'd grab his little hand. If he says it's his strong hand, I'm not ableist. It's like I would grab Camel Moon's hand if he reached out for me to grab it. So
I wouldn't.
How was everyone's Christmas in the chat? How was your Christmas, chat people?
How was yours, Rob? I want to know what a Rob Arnold Christmas is like.
We had food, presents.
Do you get with the whole family or is it just your family?
Depends. My family's up in Noosa at the moment because my sister's moved up there. So not this year.
A lot of people didn't meet people because of Omicron. Yeah. We usually have Christmas with my dad, stepmom, you know, a whole bunch of people, and then family friends. The family friends didn't want to come this year. All right,
did you get any presents?
I got one present. I got a mug. I'm like, I'm 41 years old. I didn't get presents anymore.
It sounds like you got two presents, a mug and disappointment.
No, I love my mug. I don't know where it is. It's back inside.
I got presents.
Did you get anything? Of course, Camel Moon. Camel Moon got a new set of Jammy Jams and some action figures. And
I got the big Lego bat plane.
Did you really?
It's awesome. It's like $200.
We gave my daughter some Lego.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I didn't get Duplo. I mean, I'm not a child. And then I got a new watch. I got this watch here. Yeah.
So where's it? Can you show us the bat plane?
Yeah. Okay. One sec. Give me a second.
Apex says, the replicator, if you can't get Rob Willis to finish Shinobi Sasquatch, you should get Dal Keown. If I had the power... Mike's kicked himself, so he's gone. Mobig says, my Christmas was like the Rob Hawk. It wasn't pretty and only half the bases were covered, but I managed to stick it out. What else are you guys saying? 43 degree day. Ooh, that's really hot. I might have to do the Australian to American conversion for you guys to tell you how actually hot that is. But it's a stinker. 3 degrees. That is 109 Fahrenheit. How does that feel for you guys?
So, that was me attempting to share my screen, by the way. It just like resets the whole computer every time I try and share it.
Sam Rogers had a 43 Christmas day bankrupt, 43 degrees.
What?
43. Ugh.
Oh man, yeah, it was like 20 degrees here. It was brilliant. It was beautiful. We went out for a walk in the park. It was lovely.
109 is Arizona weather. Mm.
You want to see this bat plane?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, let me take my glove off.
You got some Twitch viewers, Bancroft. Mm. Phoenix System 80. Wow, that is huge.
Phoenix System. Welcome. Yeah. Thank you for viewing us on Twitch. How many pieces does that thing have?
2,300.
Damn, my Millennium Falcon there has 800 or something. And that took me 3 days.
I got the Batmobile 2 years ago, and that was 3,300. That took me 3 days to build. So this will probably take me 2 days.
How much does that cost? It's probably like... $300 or something.
The Batmobile was 250. I think this was 200 or maybe 220.
That's a lot in Australian dollars.
Ooh.
Minus 15 Celsius in West Canada. Damn. 68 Fahrenheit, I'd say. Otherwise, you would have melted. $200. Yeah. Lego is expensive. It's not cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Victoria got the burrow from Harry Potter, where the Weasleys live. The bus that in Harry Potter that they drive around, the purple thing, and I think some other classroom from Harry. So you got three Harry Potter Lego sets. It's insane.
Mike, we got a Phoenix. The bluey camper van.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I think we've had that. I don't know if it's like a big one or anything at some point.
I think I have to show you. I'm so impressed with Bluey toys. They're so well made.
What is that? What's a Bluey toy?
Oh, I'll show you.
You don't have any kids.
No.
Camel.
The toys are for me. I'm the only one who gets toys in this house.
The phenomenon that is Bluey. She's taking over the world.
Huh.
Old Dirty Fatty says PTP was looking at that bat plane today and it was $200 for him too.
Yeah.
It was 300 Australian. 300 Australian for the Millennium Falcon. So I don't know what that is. Watching Bancroft on Twitter, you miss the chat and have to rely on Bancroft to entertain. It just doesn't work. that's special. Yeah, we don't have anything like that. No, you know, we had the Peppa Pig camper van. It wasn't anywhere near as cool as that.
Peppa Pig looks like Playmobil.
Yeah, it's awesome.
And it's Bluey.
Is Bluey like Playmobil?
No, it's a TV show.
Oh.
It like opens up and everything. See?
Kids and toys, you got man. This for yourself, Rob? This was...
yeah.
From your wife to you?
For my daughter. But, I mean, I've had to play with it, you know. I have to make all the dolls talk.
Yeah, I built half of the Harry Potter bus.
Why can't she do it?
Well, that's she could. It was just...
No, it was fun.
I really like making Lego, but... you know, it just was... Yeah.
Did you
do something together. You know, this is what people, parents do with their children.
Oh.
They spend time with them. Nothing. We didn't get presents to each other. Our love is enough for each other. Christmas is all about the kids here. It's like, we don't really care. I mean, we care about it for the kids. Like, we like the whole Christmas thing, but the gift giving and all that sort of stuff.
You should have got her a COVID passport. That's what all wives want to see.
Well, Red says, more streams should be titled Women in a Closet. I would love to draw a woman in a closet for you, Well, Red, but...
Still not working.
No, I mean, I'll try it again, but I think it might kick me out again. Let me have a go.
That's not the worst thing. Are you going to share your screen, Camel?
If you want. Oh, I guess I have to do it. Right, sorry.
Yeah, he can't telepathically.
I forgot what was going on. Yeah. Go ahead.
You do your own flats.
I do my own everything. So like today I finished bye-bye, Mike. Today I finished this page. I did all the colors for this. And so these are just the flats. Eventually I'll go in and I'll start doing highlights and stuff. Let me take the mezzo tint off. Yeah, so you can see it. So and then I'll do like the cross-hatching inks after, but once the colors are laid in, it's easier for me to almost work backwards in that sense. And so, but before I go in, I try to close all the lines to make sure that I can just paint bucket as much as I can, kind of speed the process up. I know it's kind of a cheat, but considering it's like a cartoon, I can kind of get away with it and it doesn't look bad. Because if I show you like real close in here, you know, it's all crisp. So yeah. It looks really good. Yeah.
So when you're coloring like for other people, do you still do your own flats or do you hire someone else for that?
No, I mean, when I was doing Clint's stuff, I was doing my own flats, yeah.
Mm, cool. Let's see. My Big says, where are the chains?
Chains right here. Bam. But that'll be on the chain edition. I'm going to make a chain brush edition just for chains. But for the most part, it'll look like normal.
Every time you bring this up, man, someone asks, is it still on Indiegogo, which it is. I'll bring it up now.
Yeah, it's coming along. You know, I mean, I know it sounds egotistical to say that I like it, but I just love it. I mean, I love everything about the colors. I love the sort of old school kind of cartoon feel to it. I think people are really going to like this story. I think it's an actual story. There's something happening. It's, you know, 40 pages, 3 acts, everything you want in a comic. It's funny, you know, it's as clever as I think it is, you know, so I think people are really going to dig it.
Yeah, that's the campaign there. I can't chuck the link in StreamYard for some reason. Maybe Mike has to do it.
Well, I don't have the link. I know you. Oh, yeah, yeah. You won't be able to. You've got to do it on.
I'll do it on YouTube.
On YouTube.
And also, I mean, if you want to get it, if you want to get this version, there's going to be no second prints. There's only going to be the chain brush edition. That's going to be like the second print, but like the official first print with it looking the way it's going to look, that's only going to come out like this. And it's only going to happen on this campaign. Every other iteration of this comic will be different if it comes out, you know, in the next year or whenever.
How's your father says, I'm waiting for tossed salad.
That's issue two. No, the second issue is called Into the Spiral, and they're in space, cool. And it's they're going against the Donnie Goats character. He's the main villain, and it's sort of a rip on the Odyssey. So they're trying to get home, and you know they come across all of these. We meet Anna's tribe, like all of the sirens in space, and. There's a couple other things happening that I don't really want to give away, but you know, we meet the Cyclops, who I haven't introduced yet, but I know who the character is. So it's going to be dope.
Awesome. Is this your favorite piece that you've colored? Like, cause this is awesome.
I mean, I have a lot of pieces that I like that I've colored. I have one. I can actually show you.
All your other art sucks, Camel. This one's really good. What's going on here? That's what Rob's saying.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I don't have to put words in my mouth, but sure. Zaid says, sirens are not mermaids, Camel.
Yes, they are.
No, they're not.
Well, they are.
Phil knows this. Phil, we were talking about this when we were talking about Lost Pages, and I learned about this recently as well. Sirens are more like birds. They're like half bird, half woman creatures.
Well, in the Odyssey, they're harpies. Mermaids.
Harpies are half bird, half woman.
No, I'm just saying. We were talking about how, yeah, people... Yeah, well, it doesn't matter. Freaking comic book.
Yeah. This here, the one that I have here, this is one of my favorite colored pieces.
Yeah.
I can zoom in. This was a He-Man meets the Ninja Turtle piece that I did a couple years back.
For anything in particular or just for fun?
Just portfolio.
Cool.
This took a while too, because back in the day I had to do everything with a mouse, so I had to draw it and it was kind of with fucking miserable actually. With a mouse, what? I didn't have a pen. Yeah,
on earth can you believe that? You draw with a mouse.
And it was also hard because, you know, with the mouse, I'm right-handed when I'm a left-handed artist. So it was really a pain in the ass. Like, it was kind of a double. That's why it took me almost a month to do it, you know. But it came out pretty good. I'm happy with it.
Moby Biggs with a good one. Sirens are what Bancroft hears whenever he goes outside without a mask. That's so true.
I went into Woolworths again without a mask. It was very liberating.
It makes me angry.
Why?
Well, it's like they say wear a mask, so you wear a mask. It annoys me.
What annoys you? What are you talking about?
Why can't everyone in there should wear a mask or not wear a mask? It's not some people wear a mask.
Yeah, but no one stops you, is what I'm saying. You know. There's people in there without masks on, so I'm like, well, I'll be one of them.
Dashlin Golu Watobi says, buy followers, primes, and viewers on Cart Bancroft. Is that exciting?
That's a B Rose. That's a B Rose if you're still in there. I don't know.
Rob is a Karen.
He needs that. He's still got 120 left.
Rob is a 1,000. Professional lyricist. It's unlikely.
I cannot friggin' delete QuickTime. This is infuriating. This is absolutely infuriating.
Yeah, you would be facing these problems if you had a real computer, like a real PC, not this piece of Apple shit.
It doesn't make any sense. Like, it's all worked perfectly so many times, and now it's just like, nah. And every time I open it, it just sends me to some weird thing. I can't get rid of it. It's a nightmare. It's a nightmare unfolding before my very eyes.
I'm surprised that there hasn't been like more bank robberies during this whole pandemic. You know, like being able to
know there hasn't been.
Well, I guess I don't, because I don't really follow the news. But being able to walk into a bank like with your face covered, I mean, it's a perfect opportunity to just get it done, isn't it?
Well, I don't know if just the ability to wear a mask is really the hindrance to, you know, committing a bank robbery. There's probably other considerations going on there.
Is there?
That was like when Camel Moon was like, hey, if you were invisible, the first thing you'd do is go rape chicks. We're like, ugh. Okay, Camel. You know,
look, take a seat, people buddy. Have a problem with the truth. Okay, I'm sorry that I'm the one who exposed that, but I'm not sorry. It's true.
Oh, man, this is a nightmare.
I'm just looking at up sirens now, because you know, why not? And these are the only real sirens I could find, Bancroft.
Yeah, I bet you they have fish legs. Or fish tails.
It's from Sirens.
Mm. Come on. Yeah, like in, what's that movie? The fourth or the fifth Pirates of the Caribbean. There's all the singing mermaids that they have to fight.
Mate, you made it, siren. You made it through four Pirates of the Caribbean.
What?
You made it
General Piggy, thank you so much for $4.99. Says, dank dab your worries away, Rob. Give it a dab. There's the siren right there, Camel. That's the Greek sirens, the legendary creatures of Greek mythology.
Well, I'm not doing those. I'm doing mine. They can go fuck themselves.
Yeah, no, that's fair enough. I mean, I did the same thing. I
don't know if anyone knows.
My name was Gilgamesh. If anyone comes at me and is like, Gilgamesh was not like this or didn't do that, I'd be like, well, he's in my comic.
So he's wrong in your comic. That's what you're saying.
Look, I don't know if people know this, but Hail Salad isn't based on reality. So I'm not too worried.
I'm
breathing. Yeah, I know. It's not a documentary.
Zaid says, Camel would get away with it too because they wouldn't even feel it.
I don't know what that means.
I mean,
it wouldn't feel what?
Well, he's talking about when you're invisible and you're doing your thing.
Oh,
yeah.
Then it's like, win-win.
Oh,
what
is that?
What is that breeze? Like,
I'm getting.
I had an itch. A slight itch.
Passion says mermaids do sing though, but they are not sirens.
Great.
We're learning
everyone's right and I'm wrong. I don't care.
Yeah.
I'm still going to do it my way.
Camel, just delete all the pages you've drawn.
I'm just going to delete the stream and shame.
Hail Salad should start with, should open with based on true events.
You know what, though? It is true. It is based on true events. All of those conversations took place.
So, Mike, you're just going to contribute nothing to the stream today.
There's nothing. What can I do? What can I do? I'm trying to troubleshoot this right now. I'm looking for all sorts of things here.
Phantom Harlock says, like throwing a Vienna sausage into a toilet. I don't understand what he means.
What? You don't know what that means?
No, I have no idea.
So toilet is like a reciprocal, yeah? Mm-hmm. It's a shape that something goes into. You could also say throwing a sausage down a hallway.
Don't get it. Can you explain it to me?
No.
In depth?
Can't.
See, when a man really loves a woman,
he throws a sausage down a hallway.
Yeah, and she's at the other end of the hallway.
God. You guys have no faith in me that I understand certain things.
Is that what's happening? Okay.
Loose Women from Shaggy Bear. Oh, RP's going to explain it to me in depth. Appreciated. So, Bancroft, Camel is filling in all the gaps of his lines here. So I blame you for this, because this is what we have to watch.
I'm sorry. This is like the most excruciating part. I'm sorry, guys.
I mean, I don't know.
Also, I mean, I can... yeah.
I suppose I could do some. I mean, I suppose I could do some flatting, but I'm like essentially in Clip Studio Paint, the settings on my Wacom here, they're all wonky and I can't fix them. I have to draw on the iPad now. It's just what I'm used to, but it's not connecting.
Dude, you've had the iPad for less than a month, and I used to
draw on Photoshop, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to mix programs anymore because the line. I'm pedantic like that. I don't like the lines, so it's really annoying. But I do still color. I will still color in Photoshop. I suppose I could do flats. I mean, it's
God.
I was planning on doing some cool stuff tonight, but I just plugged it in, 10 minutes before we started, assuming it would work like every other time. And no, it's like F you. And now I can't even use QuickTime. I'm going to have to reinstall my entire operating system. It looks like what I'm reading here to get this thing to work anymore. Otherwise there's no more drawing streams at all ever. So
you watch me fill in lines.
Yeah.
KSS asks, Camel Moon, have you ever considered a Hail Salad coloring book? Yeah, actually what I think I'm going to do is offer this book as it is in line art without any cross hatching, rendering or inking. And maybe oversized so that people can, color it themselves if they want. And then what I also was thinking was on the back would be a QR code. And if you scan that, you'll get digital prints of it so that you can, color it in Photoshop if you want. Maybe I'll even have a contest or something if people are that interested. But I think I'll offer that as another version of this, as sort of a second print. But yeah, you won't be able to get this version that I'm making now as again.
Old Dirty Fatty asks, are Rob and Bancroft actually friends? Because you don't act like it. I don't know.
This is how Aussie friends act.
Maybe Human says, how does a pro artist prefer to work on an iPad than Photoshop? I guess we'll ask one when one pops in.
No, who are you calling a pro? No, I'm working on Clip Studio Paint on the iPad. I mean, most pros work directly on the screen, I would assume. But no, there's some kind of settings, like the pressure on my Wacom tablet is all whacked out and it's not working Clip Studio Paint. It's working in Photoshop. I don't understand. I can't get them to work together.
I hope you feel bad because Malin is here and he says, Cecil has bought us. Here we are now, entertainers. You can't even get a drawing up.
I can't get a drawing
unbelievable.
Up.
Unbelievable.
KSS says, Camel Moon, you're going to have a contest. Will I get a 4? Only if it's really good. Only if you deserve something much, much higher will I give you a 4.
Green Laser says, Mel didn't have the time to do the Bancroft art before the stream today. That's what's going on.
I wouldn't have loaded up a stream if that was the case. I would have made sure she had it all laid out for me, ready to go. And no, just not working.
People are upset they've missed out on Cecil streaming. Phantoms. Brian says, get John on the stream.
John can always pop in. All right, if he's bored and... I I mean, I really do not want to upgrade my freaking.
Oh, is it forcing you to upgrade?
I think I somehow ruined QuickTime. Like it first it said it can't read the iPad for some reason.
And then
I was just playing around with QuickTime trying to get it to work, and then I've made some sort of selection, so now every time I open up QuickTime, it just takes me to some strange screen that I can't escape from. There's no getting out of it.
It's really interesting. So I've got
to like reset, and there's no way to reinstall QuickTime without reinstalling your whole operating system. It just doesn't exist.
John says, be funny, or you're going to have mass suicides in here because of Cecil.
Why? What did Cecil do?
I don't know.
I know he was on Ethan's. They were watching some old thing.
Cecil has shaken my faith.
Mo says, Bancroft's technical difficulties are that Mrs. B trolled him by drawing that homoerotic Gilgamesh panel last week, so now he doesn't trust her to draw the book. Yeah, I need more hetero sexuality, please.
Can you at least bring some art up or something? We can at least talk about some art or look at some art or something.
I'm really, there's nothing that gets under my skin. Nothing gets under my skin more than computers not working as they should. This is as close as anyone is ever going to see me to being angry. This has got me upset.
Speaking of which, mine is kind of on the fritz. I'm going to restart and come back. I'll see you guys in a minute.
All right. See you, Camel.
Going to have to do some flatting. Like, this is ridiculous.
For some unknown reason, there are 62 people in here at the moment. So, I mean, if you can hit like and subscribe, it's usually a lot better than this, really. It really is.
I've been looking forward to doing these drawings all day. I had them all set up. I was like, yesterday, last night, I was like, these are the ones I'm going to do on the stream. I'm going to impress everyone with my speed and prowess.
John says, I love the tech talk, but can you guys make it more racist or something? Well, I mean, it's all about those
K-levels. Talk about that Norseman trailer that got Malin in trouble.
What?
Because he was like, this looks so great. It's just white people. Which is a valid argument, because that's the history. It's like, what was it, The Witcher, set in Poland as well? But apparently he got people upset when he said that.
Did you see the post on Reddit where the guy, his wife bought him a PS5 and he bought her a book in return? I'm like, that dude's going to get fucking killed. PS5. Laura Chin says, how are y'all? Rob is an awesome cheerleader. Thank you.
Well, Mel said to me, we're not buying each other any presents. And I'm like, yeah, I know, because we got so much for the kids this year, and just, you know what it's like. But then she went and she bought me my mug. So I was just sitting there with nothing to give. That's what women do.
Yeah. Just they keep it one step up from you, don't they? Just to keep you down.
That's one way of putting it.
How else would you put it?
John said he triggered Mark Brooks. Yeah, he went into a big tirade on Twitter. It was pretty funny. Did you see that?
Nah. You can show me, though.
Yeah, all right. I mean, this has turned from a drawing stream into a
shit talk stream.
Yeah, going on about. Everyone's already said it, but what the hell?
Lord Nemesis says some homophobia would also be cool. Dude.
Okay. Well, I mean, we've had 3 weeks of that with Gilgamesh. I thought you guys would be ready to move on. Where is it? Who is this Mark Brooks guy anyway? Should I know who he is? I'm out of the loop.
Did I see that Heather Antos has got another job in comics? Is that what I saw?
Yeah, I think she's head editor.
Oh
at IDW.
It's like a boomerang.
What's this? There's a thread here.
Antoine says, Malin, Mark Brooks has been jumping in my shit lately, and I have no idea why. That's interesting.
Because you are living proof, Antoine, that he is full of shit. Let's have a look here. Using myself as bait. So, but essentially I think he retweeted. Let me go back to the source here. Let me go back all the way to the beginning. Hold on a sec. Twitter. John Malin.
Oh, that's cool. Ooh. Guts is a space marine.
Sick. Thought you'd like that.
Yeah.
John Malin. John Malinga. Yo, beauty.
Mate. We should just start calling everyone like with Australian slang.
What do you think of this? I saw this the other day.
I mean, yeah, that's something.
Where is it?
Kill them all, Peter.
Oh, yeah. All right. So that's, hang on. We didn't get to that first. Go back to the beginning. John Malin was having some Christmas fun, I think. Scrolling down. Whoa. Boobage. Jeez, well, anyway, John said pretty much like I said, you know, this new Northman movie looks really cool. It's all white people. It's great. And this guy, Mark Brooks, was like, look at Comicsgate. Look at their... They're revealing themselves. The mask has slipped. And, you know, everyone was like, oh, my God, they're the worst. So then he was like, I'm going to get these guys. I'm going to use my trolling powers to out them and reveal their super dark, you know, side of themselves that they only show to themselves. Tommy says, I'd never heard or noticed Brooks before he tried to save Lopresti from EVS.
Oh, mate.
So he does, he's an artist. He does mostly covers. He is also apparently a douche.
Is he good?
I would imagine. I mean, if he's doing covers art, he must be pretty good.
And so it's four, I guess.
He says, there's a deep, dark, super bigoted corner of comics. At least he acknowledges that CG. Well, he doesn't really call it CG, but he acknowledges that he says we're part of comics, but look, we're not trying to be part of this, of their thing. We left, do our own thing now. But now they say, oh, you just say you're going to do your own thing, but then you make fun of Heather Antos as editor of IDW. Say, I mean, I didn't personally. But if someone wants to, you know, why not?
To be fair, we make fun of everything.
We make fun of each other, Rob.
Yeah, yeah.
If you were Heather Antos and I was Shane Davis, you would have me blocked and have a restraining order on me. We make that much fun of each other.
Oh, my God. I know this Mark Brooks guy. Oh.
It's not racist if it's all white people, says Micah Jones. So who are they going to be racist against? White people? Checkmate. It's a good point. Well, look, I've actually recorded a video. I haven't put it out yet. It's about all this stuff, you know, diversity and everything. And it's like they will have an entire show that is just black people. Or just Asians, and it will be sold as super diverse. You know, that's a diverse show. But if you want to set a show in Scandinavia 1,000 years ago, and you just want to have all white people in it, and on top of that, if you think that's a really good idea and that's what you want to see and you want to celebrate that, apparently you are one of the dark, super bigoted Aryan nationalists. Because... You know, they can't stand that you know, anyone with a skin tone lighter than, you know, milk chocolate can have any sort of culture. Anyway. There's a deep, dark, super bigoted corner of comics that I stepped into yesterday. It was depressing. They're pretty well shunned from the awesomeness that's comics. That is hilarious. We're out, fellas. We're out. We're shunned. It's like, imagine this awful party of just losers, right? And they're all in this hall and everyone's just kind of standing by themselves, looking all sad. And then outside down the road, there's this cool party. There's punk music and alcohol and, you know, everyone's having fun. And they're like yelling at us from down the road. You can't come in here. You're shunned. You're not allowed in here. We're well shunned from the awesomeness that's comics. So guard the border and don't. This is the most important part. Don't go into that corner. Like, that's the important part. Like, don't go over there and find out what's on the other side of this fog that we're putting up, because it's super bigoted. The only thing that's going on there is it's a shitty, sad place where creativity goes to die.
Which is ironic, considering they only work on the same characters over and over again, and everything we create is new.
Oh, and, you know, we're able to have fun. And now they've started making fun of YouTube. Like, anyone who does YouTube, that's like, oh, that's so sad. Oh, what did that? One of these losers was on Twitter today saying, oh, poor little sad Shane, who's in the chat. Hey, Shane, how you going? He's forced to make YouTube videos like the has-been and he is. And everyone's like, moron. He's made 300 and...
They're calling Shane a has-been.
Yeah. Let me find it. Look, I got to... This is what I'm saying. Hold on. I got to open a new tab. This is... Like, I don't know. Something going on with SJWs lately. We've triggered them in some way. See, I was going to draw this panel. I can't. I'm locked out. Anyway, where is it? I know it must be in my tweets and replies. Where is it? This guy here, right? So
poor little Shaney Poo.
Yeah. So Shane just tweets, you know, a YouTube video that he does, like as he's many of his done. Now I've fucked up, have I? Damn it. Here he is. So Ian Jeffrey says, poor little Shaney Poo has to make videos to make money now because all the work dried up when he showed his true colors. Has-been's gonna has-been. This guy. And Crackhead's like, look at this. This is in December 2020. I mean, this is not that long ago. This is $370,000 raised in under 2 years.
That's half a million. But he's a has-been. Dollary dues.
He's a has-been.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, this is what I'm saying. Like, they're like, don't, to their fans, don't go over there, whatever you do, and find out that people are can having
make money off success, comics.
People are having fun. Yeah, even like, you know, guys like you and I, we can like, who they would never have heard, like we haven't even heard of them, and they're supposedly someone.
Yeah.
Of course they would never have heard of us. You know, we're probably making more than they could on crowdfunding comics.
Yeah, well, I mean, we haven't had to put out GoFundMes for our rent, Bancroft.
Not yet. I'm a was-been, says Shane. And it's just so hilarious. I don't know what's going on with them, but it's so, yeah, this so that thing that he did here, this super dark, like, this was his troll, right? He got quite a few likes on that.
I know, it's strange, isn't it?
And then he's like, using myself as bait. So he sacrificed himself. to get all the Aryan nationalist fans of a certain group of pseudo-comic creators to show their true faces for all to see was something they did not see coming. Did it because there's lots of CGs that love to say, we just want good comics. No, they don't. They truly don't give a shit. Their cult leaders want to destroy the industry that kicked them out for being unbearable assholes. See what they're saying? Like, it's like, don't go over there and find out what's happening. I'm going to tell you what's happening. And it's delusional. It's absolutely delusional. And we've had it hundreds of times now from people in the chat who said, I came over and I was like, I can't believe what's going on over here. I've never been in a, if they're a creator, if they're a aspiring creator, I've never found a more supportive and welcoming and friendly group of people than Comicsgate. If they're a fan, they're like, wow, look at all this energy. Look at all these, you know, people trying to really, really passionate about their books. And some of them will say, all I had ever heard of Comicsgate was this, all this sort of stuff. And then they step over the Rubicon and, and then find all this. And they're like, what the hell were they going on about? That's what happened with, lots and lots of people.
Let's keep reading it, because people listen, they don't obviously watch the whole
time. So he goes on, this is Mark Brooks. This is him like saying, talking about his epic troll that he did, and he's exposed all of us. John Malin started all of this.
John Malin starts a lot of things.
I haven't seen this. It must be after he blocked me all. Yeah, this is his post-game breakdown. We lost Camel forever.
Looks like it.
Yeah, we're all having computer problems tonight. Okay. So he goes on. He says, then they went to the bottom of the barrel and courted the dumbest people they could find, which included literal white supremacists.
Okay. Literal. Who are the dumbest people they could find? I mean, you know.
And who are the white supremacists? You would have to assume here we're talking about Ethan, because he's talking about people who got kicked out. So that would have to include John, according to them. This is according to them. Shane, Frager, maybe. I don't know.
You could call Ethan a lot of different things. I wouldn't call him stupid.
Well, I think they're the cult leaders. They're the cult leaders, right? That's what they're saying. Unhinged for $5 saying, busy writing and lettering. Just saying XOXO. Thank you so much, Jason. We were supposed to do a drawing stream, but my computer says no. So now we're just going to probably talk about this for a little bit. Shane says, I'm breeding out China. Well, get at it. We need it. We need John some says, more Davis.
I think babies. He's referring to fans.
Yeah. So here, so when he's saying, then I went to the bottom of the barrel and courted the dumbest people they could find, including literal white supremacists. So that, like, putting literal in front of it implies that the other times they're saying white supremacists is just jokes.
Mm.
That's just, you know what we mean. We mean figurative. But this time I mean literal. So that's, they're calling the people in the chat, you guys in the chat, the dumbest people they could find, and among you, these literals. He means Camel Moon, says RP. Passion says, I'm drawing and my PC works. Just saying, good for you, Passion. Good for you. My iPad still works. It just doesn't want to connect to friggin' the computer. So anyway,
they're calling the fans white supremacists.
Yes. Yeah.
That's fucked.
This is Mark Brooks, professional artist. And how many people did we count in CG? You know, some were active, active in 2021, somewhere between 10 and 20,000. We don't know the exact number.
Yeah.
Dumbest people they could find. This is the contempt they have. Just look at the replies to my post calling out one of their leaders, that's John Malin, for being a blatant racist. That's John Malin saying he was happy to see that they hadn't done what they always do now with historical fiction stories that are set in traditionally white areas of, you know, Western and Northern Europe 1,000 years ago. And not just throwing in random black people and Asian people, you know, just to tick a few diversity boxes, so it's not a 100% white show.
This shit pisses me off so bad.
It just takes you out of the. I don't know. On top of that, blatantly now they're like Anne Boleyn is black, Alexander Hamilton's black. Like it just kind of takes you out of the, what is it? You know what I'm saying. And so he was just like, oh, that's cool. And that is enough to trigger this guy and say, oh, look, they all crawled out from the woodwork, blah, blah, blah. I'm sure they're going to post some badly produced, long-winded YouTube vids. Oh, we're doing that. Well, we didn't mean to do it, all right? This is because of technical difficulty, but I'm pretty sure Ethan has talked about this. Over the next week, ignoring all the shitty people that showed themselves over the last 48 hours and pretend they just want good comics. Well, we do want good comics, but we also like to have a laugh. We also like to occasionally look back at this supposed amazing industry that we left behind and laugh at it occasionally. Is that so bad?
Yeah. The same industry that's getting raped by manga right now. It's crazy. It really pisses me off that they, like, you know, I can understand us getting called white supremacists and all that kind of stuff because it's what they do. But to call the fans that is that really grinds my gears, Michael.
I bet it does. Phantom Harlock says tokenization is racism. Mark is projecting his nasty, sticky racism all over John. It's interesting that you should say that. I also tweeted something similar because I was just. I think it was Shane. He was in a DM group just like, what is this all about? And my conclusion was exactly the same as that. I said, these virtue signalers are the online equivalent of perps who show up at the crime scene offering to help police with the investigation. That's like a real thing that happens. You know, anytime anyone offers to be a witness or help out at a crime scene, the police are like, we're going to take down that guy's name because like there's some sort of psychological thing there where if people feel guilt, they present themselves without asking, without anyone asking them to, they offer themselves up as a example of virtue. You can imagine it's probably because they have some sort of inner latent guilt themselves. I think you're wrong. Like it doesn't take any kind of really superior intellect to realize that there's something going on where you can't just have a TV show showing the indigenous inhabitants of Scandinavia without peppering in representation and diversity and that being fine. Like they're so twisted up with thoughts of racism and everything that they end up stepping over the line and doing it themselves. Tiny baby Slothdoor says that's what I said, Bancroft, he's projecting. People are saying good stuff in the chat. Mark has some kind of racist guilt, like he bullied a black kid when he was in primary school. This is what I'm thinking. Texas Mofo says this is better than watching sleeping in a chair.
Did Cecil fall asleep? Is that what's happened? Cecil fell asleep in a chair.
Oh. Mo says, I understand calling Bancroft a white supremacist. It's wrong because Bancroft eliminates all blacks from his book out of insecurity, not a sense of superiority. We're talking colors here, people. Tommy says, Shane mentioned that Brooks started around the same time he did. Brooks does really beautiful covers to sexy ladies. He gets presumably good money each month from cover work. Well, yeah, I mean, if anyone out there is a supporter of Comicsgate in any way, he just called you one of the dumbest people on earth. Antoine says, you're right, Bancroft. The guy who broke into my truck last summer offered some suggestions to the police as to what a crook might do the stolen goods. It's That's like, hilarious. It's a thing that happens. It really does. Like,
they like no to one asks themselves.
Them to come. Yeah, no one asks them to come. They go and insert themselves. And that's what virtue signaling is. Like, no normal person feels a sudden urge to just stand up and say, you know what? I think racism is bad. You know? I think people who sexually assault women should face severe punishment. Like, you don't need to say this stuff. Everyone knows it. Everyone agrees. And anytime you just, apropos of nothing, get up on a soapbox and say that, my first inkling is, what have you done? Why are you feeling the need to get up there and say this stuff and do this stuff? To be fair, I don't think Mark Brooks is a closet racist. That seems like a reach. I'm not saying these people are racists. I'm saying that this whole thing, I'm really struggling with my words here, but what I'm saying is this situation where you cannot be happy to that Northman is comprised of white people because every single show over the last 10 years has not been able to do that because they'll get attacked for being not diverse, even though it's historically accurate, you know? Like, you can't do that in 2021 without it being controversial, is what I'm saying. It's a different kind of racism, but I think it is stemmed from a form of racism. It's like this intersectionality, this critical race theory thing. You know, it's fine. It's actually great and diverse to set a story in, you know, Africa or wherever, and everyone's black. That would be normal. Everyone understands that. You know, no one is going, oh, we need Asians and white people, and, you know, in that show.
John says, why would
that's Brooks where I make think the racism lies?
Why would Brooks make noise if the money was coming in? I think he's hurting for cash. This is a grab for SJW dollars. Dude, I had an interaction with him once on Twitter. Like, I didn't know who he was. I said, this cover's really cool. Didn't know who it was. And someone said something, you know, somewhat negative about the cover, and he lost his mind.
Is that the guy?
This is Twitter, man. This is like, just calm down. Like, it's, people are going to be dicks to you on Twitter. It happens. It's just like totally out of the blue, just gone bananas. It's crazy.
Bullet Ninja asks, why am I lying about the Black Vikings? Oh, that. Okay, anyway, moving on. So he goes on, he says, and I'm sure they're going to post some badly produced, long-winded, we already read that, comics. So he's talking about, so he's saying CG is just pretending they want good comics. They don't. Yeah. They just want to, well, I don't know, have a place to be the dumbest white supremacists in the world or whatever. Comics, by the way, that are poorly written, poorly drawn, terribly produced, and very, very late. Because like I've said, the comics aren't the point. Their narcissistic anger is the point. Well, Rob is a bit angry. He's got a point there.
Can he make the same claim, though, about what they're producing in the big two? Like, some of it's fantastic, but some of it is horrible. So,
if admitted white supremacists are among them, then so be it. Where? Show me one. Have you ever met a white supremacist, Rob? Have you ever, like, come into contact with one?
No, man. And like, they say there's all these secret groups that go around and plan things. And like, I've been in a ton of like DM groups on Twitter since I've joined Comicsgate. I don't think I've ever seen one case of an organized movement against a group of people. Like, it's just, I don't know where they get this stuff from.
Well, it's look, there are clearly some kind of worldview differences between myself and this fella. Same with John, same with Ethan, like a lot of people, like, but they'll take that and then they'll turn up to 11. Like, to say that John was being racist in his tweet is just ridiculous. So, but they'll take what he said, turn up to 11, blow it all out of proportion. And then they'll label that's literal white supremacy. And then everyone who goes in there to defend John, well, there you go. They're admitted white supremacists. So that's how he twists it, you know, that's how it works.
Like, just on the point about Comicsgate comics for a second, right? Mm-hmm. They're all not all of them are the best comics ever made, right? There's improvement, but I can't see anyone trying to make a comic that looks like this.
There are some.
But yeah.
Your point stands. There are poorly written, poorly drawn, poorly produced, very, very late books in Comicsgate. Yes, there are. There's some. That's exactly your point is that there's exactly the same in corporate comics, in indies and actual like DC Marvel comics.
And but there's also like top level stuff exactly. Coming out of Comicsgate as well.
Exactly. We can put our best against their best any day.
Yeah.
Any day. So It's a nonsense, but it's like he's going to use that as evidence that, you know, we don't care. Mm. We're not here for the comics. We're just here for the supremacy. Well, just like Eric said. See, and this is the thing, right? Eric can come into the chat here and say this. I don't care about comics. I'm just here for the bigotry. And we know Eric. We've been hanging around with Eric for years now. So we know Eric is having fun on a stream, making jokes. We can make these jokes. I appreciate this joke. I would give him a little thumbs up for this joke. I like it. But they will take that and say evidence.
Mm-hmm.
Evidence that these guys are who they are, who we say they are. Shane says, CG doesn't have 80-odd years of comics. Another good point. We're 4 years in. Considering we're 4 years in, and working with a kind of, I mean, it's not new, but it's pretty new in terms of crowdfunding and everything. At least a lot of the people who are doing it for the first time. I mean, Shane has had to
exactly
learn how to be his own, you know, marketing machine and fulfillment and all that sort of stuff.
Like you and I, we're first-time creators, right? And mm-hmm. we're trying to create the best possible stuff we can. I mean, what's their excuse?
Well, there's probably a lot. I mean, there's lots of excuses. We go on a tangent here about, you know, they're rushed and they're making pamphlets and like I alluded to earlier, they've got to tick off boxes. We're not worried about ticking off diversity boxes. We're not worried about making our comics woke. It's my opinion that if you try and make anything woke, it's gonna be crap. Like that saying that Trump said, you know, everything woke turns to shit. I think that's true. These guys might disagree. They might think, no, it makes it better, whatever. Well, I think it's making your comics crap, and your movies and your TV shows. So there's the difference of opinion.
What's happened in the last 10 years that it's all turned to shit? It's not just one thing.
It's a thousand different things.
Yeah.
It would take hours to go into it, but
a thousand tiny cuts.
Exactly. Yeah. What does he go on to say? I'm sure there are people in CG that aren't racist. Oh, I'm sure there's some good eggs in there. I just think that it's All right, okay. So there are some people in CG that aren't racist and just think it's a movement about comics. They seem to do the bidding of their masters like they're told.
Yeah, that's the thing again. Like, there's no one telling us to do anything. That's
yeah, but this is what I'm saying about projection. You know, like you're. I don't want to say that he's in a cult, but I think from what I'm gleaming here, not knowing the guy, he does definitely seem to be on the woke side of things. Let me see if he has the pronouns in his bio. He does. He's got pronouns in his bio. So I'm going to just assume that he's woke, quote unquote.
Oh, he, him.
Yeah. So to me, I think he's in a cult. I think that is a cult mentality, right? That's my impression of it. So he's going to project that onto Comicsgate. And he's going to interpret people agreeing with Ethan when he says something or agreeing with Shane as they're just doing their master's bidding, doing as they're told. All right. Considering we're talking about Shane here, I should probably grab some of his comments. He says, I'm glad Mark said some of some of us, not all of us. Probably not you. He's probably not talking about you, Shane, to be fair. Eric says, Ethan told me to trade all my dollars to him for Ribbit coin. What a great investment. Ribbit to the moon. Ethan is making me watch public domain movies, and I can't think for myself. Step out of the bubble there, Sonanami. What should we do about this, Master Bancroft? Well, donate to my PayPal.
You've got 80 people in here, mate. You can send them all to do something.
I know. Mark can't make six figures, young lady. That's why he hurts. Bingo. That's why he puts up the wall. I call it the haze, the fog, because it's not really a wall, because all you have to do is walk through it. All you have to do is literally walk through it. So they've got the industry, the main corporate industry. It's also, you know, where a lot of the indies hang out. And then they've put up this fog wall of propaganda, and they say to everyone, don't go through that fog. It's the worst on the other side. It's just the worst people ever. You know, it's miserable. They're all racist. Like, don't go over there. And the reason they say this is because they don't want to lose people to come over here and see all the fun we're having and all the money that's getting made, the comics that are getting made, because, you know, they try and keep it like the only comics. You hear these people talk about CG, they'll make out like there's only Ethan and Zach, sometimes Shane, sometimes John. There's only Cyberfrog. There's only Jawbreaker. Yeah. Like, that's
and
it.
Everyone else is a failure, even though like a guy like you and me can make $40,000, which is incredible for us.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They don't. If you're a young, struggling indie person, don't throw your career away. Don't throw your future away by going over there and getting you know, involved in that network and meeting people and getting help and potentially making 40, 50, 60, Clint Stoker's getting close to 100,000. You know, don't do that. Stay here and make, you know, 4,000, because if you go over there, you'll make us look bad, because you know, crazy. you were making $1,500 over here. If you go over there and make 30,000, that's more than I make. And we don't want to do that. So I'm going to make sure I don't miss any.
Lots of good chats in the chat.
Lots of good chats. Boss battle every time you cross the fog. CG. Look at these words. A miasma of racist incels. Okay, so Mark Brooks has a question to all of those in CG who's essentially according to him, a useful idiot. Not racist. Do think it's about a movement about comics, but they are unfortunately doing the bid as their masters. He's got this question for you.
Mm-hmm.
He says, go through the racist Aryan nationalist post that popped up after I stood up to one of CG leaders. That's John Malin.
Okay.
Do you see a single reply from one of the leading voices telling them to stop?
Oh.
Telling them that they're not wanted in CG. Any single word of condemnation? No, idiot, because we agree and we're having fun. And if we're telling jokes, we're having fun and telling jokes. because that's what guys do. I don't know if you remember that. We'd like, we get together and you know, we shoot the shit and we have fun and we don't take everything so damn seriously.
And again, it's John and Ethan and Shane and whoever else you want to call in charge of CG. Don't go and tell us to do things. So they're not going to say stuff like that.
Again, oh, there you go. Great point, Rob. Here's his mask slipping a bit. Where that's how he sees it.
Yeah.
That's how he sees it. As like Ethan is sitting on a throne with robes. And we're all humming, you know, surrounded him with candles going, oh, you know, because they actually have like thought leaders in over there in the industry that you can't say anything against. And anyone who's tried gets, you know, summarily, it's what did it come out that, you know, freaking, what was it? I don't know, you know, that group where they're all conniving against people. Shane was in there.
the Whisper Network.
The Whisper Network, that's the one. Everyone is welcome here, says John Malin. Well, I don't know about Mark Brooks.
maybe not Mark Brooks.
Bullet Ninja says Ethan sits on a throne of pies. He's just like sitting there and he's like cracks off a bit on the side. Okay, so we might actually have to do this. We might have to actually go through these racist Aryan nationalist posts. So I'm expecting talk about, some real, this has to, like, for this, to use these words, it has to be some real heinous shit. And I expect it to be, you know, prominent people that Rob, you and I would know in CG. And then we'll go over there and look at that after this. Nope, you got complete silence. They know that who they are and who their base is. We're afraid to call out Aryan nationalists because we don't want to lose backers.
The fuck? This is crazy.
Antoine says, I think we'd all be holding lit crack pipes, not candles. Good point. Good point. Passion, you're right. God, if Mark Brooks ever found this channel,
oh my
god, you imagine weeks of getting the K values down and whew. I fly under the radar.
For now.
Where did I get up to? Not a single word of condemnation. You get complete silence. Standing up to the shittiest members of their fan base equals death. Hyperbole? death.
Hyperbole.
So this long post isn't to them. They're lost in their anger. Again, maybe Rob is. Not me. I can't get my... I may have friggin' broken my computer, and this is me at my most angry right now.
It's disappointing.
This is as high as it gets. They caught the worst of society for profit. That's the fans. That's you. That's the fans out there. They caught the worst of society for profit. That's Mark Brooks. I don't know if he works for Marvel. I mean, he's got Captain America. I presume he works for Marvel.
That's Antoine.
Telling you that you are the worst of society.
That's Antoine. That's Oliver from 656. That is
all of us.
Any number of people.
I will, Mark. I'll calm down. I'm not really a ranter. I'm not like John Malin or Shane, but...
Or me.
He started. This is for you CGers that might not have realized that all this stuff until now. Thank goodness Mark Brooks is there to tell all the CGers.
Thank you. Thank you, Mark.
It really is. You're better than this, and comics are better than them. You've been told. We're not good enough for comic books. No one is saying you have to like everything produced. Thank you. Thank you for saying that. Hell, I don't either. Well, that's pretty much the entire, you know, first year of Comicsgate. That's what it was. But there's something for everyone and for every taste. You don't have, here you go. You know, he's calling out what we do. You don't have to pay $25 for a badly made book that you get every 2 years. Hey, My book is not badly made. It's very well made. You don't have to fall for their bullshit. You're being conned and used by people that the industry showed the door to, presumably, because they're unbearable people. You're being used by them. If you didn't know this before, you know now. Thank you, Mark. You're shoulder to shoulder with racists and con men. I know you're better than this. At the very least, you're better than them. It's a low bar, but one I know you can leap over. With that, I'm done. I've wasted enough time on these people. I wanted them exposed, and they obliged. They know who they are, and more importantly, you know who they are. There you go. He's going back to do some dad jokes and kick-ass artwork. Yeah. Hashtag go comics. What do you reckon, Rob?
Like, where do you even start, man? Like, it's just
we have to find his we have to find him exposing John Malan, because that's where all the Aryan nationalists.
You got Pete Callan for $5.
He says, "Thank you so much, Pete." He says, "I love these SJWs, especially the gay ones that tell us we're anti-women. I'm anti-women. I love women so much. I married one. Can they say the same again?" Yes. We find out so many of these people who jump up and yell incel and woman hater and all that are lonely, weird types who've maybe had a girlfriend once or twice in their life. Whereas you looked anywhere in Comicsgate, you'll find married men, married women, fathers, mothers, all the time. Not everyone, but you can't throw a rock in CG without finding just a regular dad.
Yeah, or mum. We have people of different sexual orientations. We have people of different skin colors. It's never an issue. It's never brought up as this person can or cannot be in here. Everyone is welcome here.
All right.
Is that true?
Except for Camel Moon.
Damn. I'm sorry I left. I was engaged in Cecil's sleep stream.
Oh, really? You left for a better stream?
He's unbelievable.
Oh, it's so much better. No, I was having issues with my hard drives. They kept, ejecting themselves, and nothing was saving, so I had to, do a fresh restart and, inject them and put them back, put the USB back in and everything. It was kind of a pain in the ass.
Mo says, Bancroft didn't let his own gayness stand in the way of finding a good woman. Well, it's hard to have a gay time on your own. John says, you can't throw a rock on CG without hitting a woman. That's I stand by what I said. Zaid says, my girlfriend is stacked.
Pictures or we don't believe you.
Yeah.
It doesn't need to be full, right. Just of the stacked part.
All right, so he's got a response here from George Hand R. Martin. I don't know who this fellow is.
Hard
R.
Yeah.
Oh, right, Hard George. R. Right, yeah. Okay. Big comic skater, I guess. I don't know. Let's have a look. I don't know. I'm not seeing much shilling of Comicsgate in here. All right, okay, but this is according to Mark, one of us, CG. I don't know. I don't know. He's got some ideas on Jewish representation in the media.
Don't have those views. Those views never get anywhere and anywhere. That's good.
Where are the posts from people that he's talking about?
Well, this is what I'm trying to find. So okay, here's Malan responding back to Mark. So it must be before this. I'm trying to scroll down. I mean, not that long ago. All right. All right, this must be it. So there's John Mann saying, the Northman Trail is so white from the snow to the people. You just made my day. Mm-hmm. Right? So he's like, this movie looks amazing. I can't wait to see it. But what the hell is wrong with these brain-broke people? John gets back to him. Twitter includes, oddly under black tears, I can't find a single here. It's gift press. So John's having fun with Mark. Now, where are the... I'm trying to find the Aryans. We're on a hunt for Aryans. Well, I mean, not Aryan. What, I don't know what that means. Aryan nationalist? Right. And they have to be Aryan nationalist white supremacists. And they have to be in CG. And on top of that, like, no one says anything. But when they're out there spouting their white supremacy, no one calls them out on it. All right, looking for the responses. Okay. I mean, I'm not seeing anyone I recognize. I'm not saying I know everyone in Comicsgate. I mean, I don't know if anyone can. That's, you know, a lot of people. But I know a lot of people who frequent CG on Twitter. Okay, I didn't find anything. Maybe it was in the other tweet. Because he said to us, he said, hey, you guys out there who are just normal guys who just want to make good comics, go to these threads and look at all of the Aryan nationalists who responded to my tweets celebrating who are part of CG. Okay, so here we got Patrick Thomas Parnell. He says, God bless John Malin. Okay.
Who? That's funny. Who?
Right.
You got Pete Callum for $5. It's okay to root for the home team unless you're white, then it's racist.
Yeah, that's where I'm saying the racism lies. Like, it's very one-sided, you know. Like, you can't, it's celebrated to celebrate indigenous cultures that aren't white. This is essentially what I'm saying. But if the indigenous culture is white, you can't have that.
Yeah.
You can't like that. You can't enjoy it. You can't like the fact that it's historically accurate at the very least. And it's not like, I mean, that would be an odd thing to celebrate apropos of nothing, but for the last, you know, especially 5 years, there's been a concerted effort to make sure that that is not represented anywhere. And then that's actually frowned upon. Thank you so much for the super chat. Well, I mean, I'm looking, I'm waiting. I'm gonna hazard a guess, guys, and say that the Aryan nationalist contingent of Comicsgate doesn't exist. I'm just gonna
but I make that that's guess. Why I thought we were all here. I thought we were all I'm so confused. All right.
See, you couldn't make that joke if you weren't in Comicsgate.
That's true.
The camel's making these jokes. You know, they don't want to take it out of context. Best to just cancel it.
You can't even argue with these people because they believe what they say so strongly that there is no wiggle room in their beliefs at all.
It's mostly just people not liking what John Malin said.
Well, people hate the truth. You know, they'll fight it. They'll try to, demonize and twist your words anyway, you know, to try to get whatever result out they want. That's why I can't listen to these people. I mean,
is it really?
They're a waste of time.
Is it really all based on George Hard R. Martin? well-known comics gator. And what is this? Hang on, let me go back. Okay, so you got this guy, Lyle Coleman, has put up a tweet. He says, Derek Hand says, pray tell, what is white culture exactly? Also, there's plenty of evidence that the Vikings were black and even Middle Eastern. Yeah. So this guy, George R. R. Martin, makes this statement. And then, so this guy's got Ethan holding it. Like, what does this discussion have to do with Ethan Van Sciver? You know? So where's the authenticity in this? This is just nonsense.
Anton says, nonsense. To me, it's just about the authenticity and being able to immerse oneself in a piece of art. I'm not happy that everyone is white in my European mythology. It's just right.
Yeah, but that's what they're interpreting it as. That John just can't stand looking at people who have melanin in their skin, rather than he's like, oh, you know, this is cool. It's not going to be a woke fest of fake diversity forced onto a Viking show. Which is what we've kind of come to expect over the last 5 years, especially. And anytime someone like says that, articulates that, you get all these people going, oh my God, the sky's falling in. And then John's like, well, I'm going to have some fun with you losers, you know? I don't know. I didn't find anyone. I didn't expect to find anyone. That's why obviously you've seen me. I've been going through these just haphazardly. With 100% confidence, 100% confidence that I would not find anyone who I know who hangs around in Comicsgate out there espousing anything that would be, you would be able to label as anything close to, as he termed it, Aryan white supremacism, nationalism on Twitter. I've not seen it, never even alluded to. There's an absolute confidence that I wouldn't find anything. Otherwise, I would have had some egg on my face, but there will be no egg on my face because turns out this guy's just full of shit.
Peter Gilmore says, only stuff are even remotely racist I found was on accounts I've never heard of that are clearly sock accounts. The only one time, Bancroft, I can think of someone saying something that was not good was homophobic, and that was called out by multiple people in the chat, and the person removed that stream. So,
only time I can remember. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Why is Mark Brooks taking away opportunity for POC creators? He should be stepping aside and letting these creators do Marvel and DC covers.
That's a good idea.
White witch Democrats be white witch white rich behaving like authoritarian hypocrites. Well, I mean, I don't know anything about this guy's politics, other than he puts he him in his bio, which to me, you know, 99% of the time, woke, right? Like most regular people don't feel the need to do that, and it's become like a symbol, you know, that you put out there that, you know, because they think they're like, oh, we're going to annoy the right kind of people. Antoine says, if I watched a film about Crips versus the Bloods and there were Asians and whites sprinkled in there in the ranks of actors, I'd be exactly. But, then they're not going to get that. I mean, everyone understands this implicitly, and the fact that we have to explain it is insulting to everyone's intelligence. But, you know, this guy with 42,000 followers out there is running around screaming about white nationalists in Comicsgate, you know, beyond the fog, but just don't go in there. And I've been in there and looked. You don't want to go in there kind of tactics.
I just don't understand how people care about so much different things. Like, I don't care if you're a male, female, black, white, whatever. I just don't care.
You're so right, Rob. I did a video on it after, because I've been watching a lot of Arcane sort of breakdown videos and stuff.
Yeah.
And one of the guys was like, Arcane did woke right. I was like, what? No. Arcane is not woke.
There's
Arcane is diverse. Diverse does not equal woke. You know? Like, there's this, like, to be woke is a certain ideology of, you know, involves like critical race theory, intersectionality, you know, all this sort of stuff. And if you were to, and the guy said on the video, he's like, this is woke doing done right, because there's all these different races, and not just human races, like, you know, other kind of, there's a little weary furry guy. And no one cares. It's not part of the story. It's not like, it doesn't matter. And it's like, that's the opposite of woke. If it's woke, that's all that matters. The only thing that matters is if the person is black or trans or gay or whatever. That's it. That's the character. Whereas in Arcane, and in like most regular people, that sort of stuff doesn't matter. Is it a good character? Is it a good story?
There's no such thing as woke done right.
Exactly.
There's a movie on Netflix now that I started watching out of pure curiosity. It's called The Harder They Fall. And it's a Western, and everyone in it is black. Every single person.
Idris
Elba's in it. And it is truly terrible. I mean, you can tell when you're watching it, the director could have used about 10 years doing like, you know, Law and Order or something first before, because it was only his second movie. And it's, you know, the writing is terrible and it's very anachronistic. And it's just like, you know, a really watered down budget Tarantino influenced garbage fest. And, you know, it's like Tarantino referenced actual Westerns, but this guy's referencing Tarantino. So now it's twice removed. On top of that, yeah, it's like, it starts the movie by saying, all of these things really happen, and these are the real people. It's like, I thought everyone was a slave back then. I was like, you know, you watching this, I was like, nothing about this is real. I was like, you might as well have fucking dinosaurs running in the background, because nothing about this. I'm like, oh yeah, I totally remember all of these characters, all of these, you know, African-American people walking around, you know, with cowboy hats, shooting at each other. They go to like a casino, everyone's black. And the thing is, as I was watching, my wife was like, you have to turn this off. This is so bad. But it reminded me of in the 70s, they would do these exploitation films.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, okay, we're going to do Blackula. We're going to do Superfly, whatever it is. And it's like, and in those, the only, you know, it was like, well, the white guys were always the bad guy. And it's like, so it's just the next evolution or stage of filmmaking at this point is like, oh, we're just going to go back to the exploitation phase of filmmaking and just call it woke. And it's just, it's ridiculous. And, you know, it doesn't, it's, you know, they're all terrible. So, yeah, usually. I saw this. I was like, there's not enough slaves in this movie. You know what this movie needs? but if you ever get a chance to watch it, watch the first 5 minutes. You know what I'm talking about. It's truly awful. I mean, it's so bad.
Matterhorn says, Fast and the Furious was diverse in 2001. Fair enough, the movie wasn't great, but that diversity didn't feel forced.
Look, especially now in 2021, and you know, the last 30 years or so, the world has become, the Western world has become incredibly diverse as we know it now. But even outside of representing our culture, I mean, Star Wars, incredibly diverse, all different kinds of people, aliens and all that sort of stuff. Like, and then there's not just diversity of what you are, but there's also, you know, you can have diverse other kinds of more important diversity, which is diversity of thought and character and personality. Like, that's one of the biggest things that was one of the biggest critiques of Zack's back in the day, is every single character in these woke Marvel books was exactly the same. the way they talked, the way they thought, what they said, what they wanted, what they did. It was all just exactly the same. There was no diversity, but they would label it diverse because in woke terms, diverse just means not white, not straight, not a male.
Nothing diverse about it. Yeah, yeah. But they say, well, this is what diversity. Diversity just means anti-white. That's all it is. If it's diverse, then it's anti-white.
Do you know what really put me over the edge, Bancroft?
What?
The chick that wrote that article on Bluey. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah, but I think there's sites now where anyone can just submit stuff. Like, I think a lot of this stuff there's enough people out there in the world doing what we're doing right now. I mean, we're a tiny, tiny group of people doing it here on this channel. I think there's much like in CG alone, there's plenty of people, but then you branch out and you get Yellow Flash, Tug, all the guys, you know, tangentially related to the Phantom Menace. You've got Salty Cracker, who gets friggin' 15,000 people in his live streams. Tim Pool, you know, there's so many people calling this stuff out that it actually now behooves companies to put this sort of stuff out there purely to get the people talking, purely to get the sort of that response bait, rage response sort of stuff.
If you think about
part of the landscape in that sense.
Yeah, but if you think about like their perspective of it, it's like, okay, so you put a movie out like The Matrix, where it's just total woke garbage. It's not even, I mean, it's woke, it's kind of woke, but it's like mostly the movie is just terrible. It doesn't make any sense. The plot of the movie is to wake Neo up. That's literally it. There's no story, it's just a premise. Mm-hmm. And so they make money if it does poorly, because how many people out there are rushing to YouTube to make videos about how much they hate it? Well, those are all monetized. So it's almost like that movie, The Producers from Mel Brooks. It's like they make money even if it fails. And so it doesn't really make a difference whichever way, you know, it comes out. I mean, yeah, if it's Spider-Man 3, great, we made $1 billion. If it's not, then we make money on the back end through rage clicks, you know? And until people stop complaining about that stuff, which is not going to happen anytime soon, they're incentivized to keep it going. Back in the day, there was no such thing as rage clicks. It's like if people didn't like something, then they wouldn't watch it, you know? And so they can technically make money from people who are never going to watch The Matrix, because they'll watch tons and tons of YouTube videos on why not to watch The Matrix. So those views are still there, just in a different form.
Do you think there will be any kind of effect, though? Because, like, it does seem that every third movie that Disney puts out is a big hit. I don't know.
Yeah,
this new Spider-Man is Disney, is it? But anyway, like, surely they want Warner Brothers. Big hits.
There's a theory. It's called, I don't know what it's called. It's called, like, the theory of sequels or trilogies or something, that not every movie can be a winner. And the reason is that it's almost impossible to outdo yourself. So that studios at the top will specifically say, this one we can phone in. Because if the franchise is strong enough, people are going to watch it anyway. But then they can sort of like come back from it in the third one or the fourth one. And it's like, oh, now it's that thing you remember again. And in Hollywood, there's called the rule of fives. And it means that you have, for every success you have, you can have 5 fuck-ups after the fact. And because you'll still get, no matter, like, you know, it's like, well, you made The Matrix. We'll do Cloud Atlas and Jupiter Ascending and, you know, 2 other Matrix movies that aren't very good because whatever, you know. Oh, you did. So then, you know, eventually what came out? Not Watchmen. The one, your favorite movie, the one that's making the rounds.
V for Vendetta. But they just wrote the script on that. They didn't make that movie.
But it doesn't really matter. The point is that they attach their name to it in a really big way. Yeah. so that when people went, they knew that this was Wachowski and all that stuff. So I think that that's part of it. It's just like, you know, it's really, really hard unless you, like, you know, pull a Mel Gibson to get yourself kicked out of Hollywood. And even then, he's back. So it's like, is it really going to shift anytime soon? I don't know, because my wife was watching I guess they did Sex and the City again. So it was like a four-part miniseries. And she was watching it, and she was like, this is terrible. She's like,
she liked the show before?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, every girl her age watches it, and everyone in our generation used to watch it. So she was excited, and she was like, oh, I'll sit down. She watched it all day. It's only four episodes. And she was like, it seems like it was a movie that they stretched, you know, to try to get content out of it. But she's like, I wouldn't watch a sequel to this. Also, they didn't bring back some of the characters. So it felt very forced. And then the other characters, they purposefully made to be racist, although they had never displayed any type of racism or anything like that in the previous 10 years of the show. So it's like, you know, they're altering the characters. And I think if it's seeping into, you know, that type of mainstream, not people like us who are, you know, live and breathe entertainment media, but people like my wife who do it passingly. And then they're like, what is this? It's like, I don't understand why they're doing this. Then they could start seeing a bigger backlash where they're like, they're forced to, you know, kind of course correct. Because, yeah, I mean, if they lose the casual viewer, that's where they're going to get fucked. You know, but if the diehards don't matter, because the diehards still going to go see, the diehards are still going to go out and buy the DVD of a movie they hate. They just will. But if they can lose the people who are, you know, just, you know, because there was some show she watched. I think it was called Project Runway. And it's about these ladies who
dresses. Yeah, Mel watches that. Yep.
And on the second episode, I had like just kind of walked into the room, and this one woman, she left the whole show because they accused her of being racist. And it was this whole thing. So I was like, babes, can you rewind this? I watched the whole episode with her. And essentially it looked like to me a staged event. Like she said something that she shouldn't have said. And then they called her on white privilege and all this. I was like, so you have to assume that like this must have, because if it's supposed to be a reality show, only so much of this, you know, is going to be, it can actually be true, right? A lot of it is edited and put together. And I was like, what are the odds that something like this would happen on an edited show? You know? So I think that because of that, they, If she noticed it and then she was like, you know, she stopped watching it. Like, there's a show she watched seven seasons of, you know.
Rob, what's this terrible, awful looking book that is, you know, poorly produced and 2 years late?
Replicator 3, waiting on the proofs. They're printed, but he can't get them to me because of bloody Christmas and Boxing Day and all that kind of stuff. So
who would have imagined you send proofs on like the 23rd of December that you wouldn't get them straight away?
Well, I mean, you know, we all hope, but yeah, I mean, hopefully we should be printing it very soon. But yeah, it looks that awesome. Some guy did some good work on the colors, and so yeah,
you got a shit hot colorist there, I reckon.
Yeah, not bad. Yeah, at least a 5 out of 10.
5 out of 10 ain't bad.
Yeah, no.
It's better than a 4.
It is, yeah. Yeah, but yeah, just putting it up on the screen while we're talking. And yeah, it's really good. The art's really good. The story's really good too. But Camel, actually, I had a question for you, right? I was scrolling through Reddit.
Is it about Project One Way? Because I know everything about that show.
It's not.
It's about Project Boom Way.
I haven't seen the latest Spider-Man, but by all accounts, it's one of the best ones that they've done. Is that a fair statement? Or at least up there?
I mean, of the Tom Holland. Yeah, I would say of the Marvel movies, it's probably the top 5 or 6 Marvel movies. I mean, it's the best movie they've put out since Infinity War. That's for sure.
So, you know, I'm no expert on the whole way Hollywood works, but I saw a post saying now that they've done this one, it's the perfect time to bring in Gwen Stacy for the next Spider-Man movie. What do you think?
Didn't they already do that?
Well, so I heard a rumor that they were low-key talking about bringing back Andrew Garfield to finish off his trilogy, and then they would somehow bring Gwen Stacy into that, although she's dead now, so I don't quite understand how that would work. I don't think it matters. You know, I mean, it's like, is it really going to make a difference? I mean, it'll make $500 million or $500 million, and then people will just be like, yeah, that was fine. They'll forget about it in 2 years. I don't think it's going to hurt the series in any way. You know, I don't think it's going to, like, ruin the brand.
I have a better question than that, Camel.
Well, just okay. Throw my dramatize, question under the bus.
Drama, yeah, that question, who cares? Dramatize me Project Runway.
Ooh.
We get on Camel Knights, and we EFAT Project Runway's
virtue signal. Ever?
Yeah, I don't know about that. But I'll tell you this. this New Year's, we're doing a Camel Nights, and two of the actors from Dramatize Me are going to be on the stream.
Wow.
So
for people who don't know what we're talking about, this could potentially be
the biggest Camel Nights episode.
Well, one of the biggest events in the Comicsgate YouTube of the year. This is massive.
No one knows what you're talking about.
Well, look. Yeah. anyone who isn't, we've got 93 people in here. We're probably going to end this here. This was supposed to be a drawing stream, but my computer broke. Camel's computer broke. So we just started chatting about crazy SJWs on Twitter. And we got 93 people in here, which is great. Thank you, everyone. So if you don't know, Camel Moon down here has a channel. It's called Camel Moon. Hopefully someone can have a link there in the chat for him. And it's Friday night, isn't it? Saturday.
Yep. Friday for me.
Well, I mean, look,
it's hard for us, Camel. Yeah. We're on a different
I do it Saturday afternoon, so it's like, it's weird. Really fun show with Camel, John Malin, myself, and Captain Chokeout.
The second best show in CG.
It's all up in the air. do make sure you subscribe. There you go. Thank you so much, Crackhead. Rob Arnold here. There. He has a channel. It's called The Replicator, and we do weekly shows over there as well. We talk crowdfunding and stuff like that. Obviously, on this channel, I do Late Night with Comicsgate 4 nights a week. Camel and I have a new show that we got in the works, which will be a lot of fun.
What is it?
Please be quiet, Rob.
You know nothing. You will know nothing until it starts. Now, we'll probably announce the type of show, obviously, before. I don't want people showing up and be like, ugh. But I'm not going to say anything until we're, you know, probably about a week out.
Is it a try not to laugh show?
No.
That's why you're going
to
be.
Want you to laugh.
Yeah, it's going to be a big.
Lord Nemesis jerk. Says we've got 103 likes, but only 92 in the chat. Bancroft has alt accounts liking his videos. Confirmed. 100 likes is great. That is awesome. Thank you so much, guys. So please, if you enjoyed this show tonight, this impromptu, whatever we did here, please do subscribe to all of us, like and all that sort of good stuff. It helps us out. Dunn Ringhill says, I'm not racist, but Michael Bancroft puts up some very convincing And Jeremy says, it's my forward alt. It's the Russian bot, says Darren. Thank you, everyone who came to hang out with us tonight. I hope next week I can get this thing sorted, because I do want to get back to drawing on stream, because I enjoy that.
Bancroft, I've got a question for you. Since there are 91 people or 90 plus people in here during pretty much the whole stream, and you weren't drawing, does that tell you something?
No. We just had a hot topic. I mean, I think you asked to bring that up. So congratulations to you, Rob. Well done. Well done. Everyone loves watching me try to draw and fail. It's a big draw card. Yes. All right. So I'll be back in a couple of days with Late Night with Comicsgate. Until then, hope you all have a great night. And I'm going to take you out with this wonderful video right here. phenomenal.